It's Monday morning. You're sipping coffee at your desk, casually browsing the web. Suddenly, a notification pops up, an email from IT. Critical incident, potential virus found on your machine. Your heart skips a beat. Did you leak something? An SSH key? A sensitive file? You rush to monitor incoming and outgoing traffic, but how do you do that? What tools should you use? And wouldn't installing more software potentially break additional things? Panic sets in as you realize you're not prepared for this. Oh, you wish you had tools to answer all of these worries before hitting an emergency. What if I told you the answer was right in front of you all along? That your terminal, yes, your terminal, could be your first line of defense. Today, I'm going to show you how to transform your terminal into a powerful security hub. No need to install complex software or risk further system instability. We'll explore built-in tools and lightweight utilities that can help you monitor, analyze, and secure your system all from the comfort of your familiar command line. We're going to cover encrypting your secret files with keys or passwords, sending them securely over to other machines, monitoring in and outgoing traffic, and even manage your machine connections right from your terminal with fancy interfaces working for you. Let's get into it. The first tool is both a CLI and a Go library that can be used with other implementations. With almost 16,000 stars on GitHub, AGE is an incredibly popular option for file encryption. It can use keys, passwords, create keys for you, and lots of other options. AGE is pretty much available everywhere, starting from Homebrew and Mac ports through an Alpine package, something you don't get a lot, Debian, Fedora, even Nix, and I use Nix, by the way, so a snob like me would go ahead and add packages.age to my home flake. A short Darwin build and AGE is ready to go. More on Homeflake and Nix Darwin in the video above. To get started with AGE, we need a key, and it comes with a handy tool called AGE-keygen. Like the standard keygen, many Unix users are familiar with. Now that I have a public key, I can use it to encrypt files. The file itself holds the private key, which will be used for decryption. Let's start with a simple one. Echoing a text and piping it to Edge, taking the public key and writing the result to a secret file, results in an encrypted, unreadable data. To decrypt, run AGE-D with the file and write the results into yet another file. If we cat secret1-decrypted, now it shows the output as it was written. Files can also be encrypted in a PEM format, like a certificate, using the --armor flag. I'll use the same key and write the output to secret.pam, which, as you can see, was written in a certificate format. AGE can also be encrypted with a password. With -p, AGE asks for a passphrase and a confirmation to encrypt. What I like about it is that, different from other encrypted PDF files for example, trying to open it doesn't pop a request for a password, but just shows corrupted data. Only upon decryption, AGE realizes the file is password protected and asks for it to reveal its contents. Let's push things a little and encrypt something more complicated like an image. Yazi shows a secret.jpg file that we can use. Similarly, we'll password protect this image and write it to an encrypted image file with a super secret password that's totally not the word secret. Trying to read it looks uninviting, for the lack of a better word, so let's go ahead and run the same process as earlier for decryption. When ready, I can pop Yazi again and view the decrypted file, which was reversed in good condition and is now visible again. Next on the list is a TUI that's simple, but so nice to have around. sshs is a terminal user interface for SSH. It picks up your sshconfig and lists it for you to choose. If you've configured everything properly, you never have to remember server names and their respective keys. Installation, as earlier, is widely available from Windows stations through Arch and, yes, you guessed it, Nix. Once added, Darwin takes care of the installation and sshs is ready to go. My current SSH config holds one local server, my Zima board. These few lines are similar to opening a shell and running ssh casaos at my server and adding my RSA key. But when they're configured, I can just run ssh Zima board. This is what SSH is doing, but in a list. Let's add a test server so we have at least two items and pop sshs. The UI is simple, it's a list of servers and a few details on their columns with a filter line on top. I hit Zima, provide my super secret password, and I'm in. Honestly, even with one server around, it's cool to have sshs. But if you ever work in an on-prem environment or even a cloud-based system with lots of long-living servers you need to jump into, sshs is a keeper. I'm going to use one of my favorite security platforms who were also kind enough to sponsor this video, Aikido.dev. While Aikido offer a bunch of options, including scanning your cloud production and project dependencies, I, as always, am interested in their CLI and local scanning option. Sometimes you can't win it all through the terminal, especially when it comes to security. When I scan my local containers, I usually opt for Claire, an open source container scanner, but when it comes to a more holistic approach and a serious drill down, I trust Aikido. Among many other options, Aikido scans my public image continuously and automatically so that I don't have to worry about it. The moment a container is added, Aikido launches a scan and shortly after I can see the results. I last pushed this thing 7 years ago, but it was downloaded over 100,000 times, probably by many drone CI users. This makes this list of critical issues quite worrying, to say the least. With Aikido, I can drill down further to a calculated score, a short TLDR, how to fix, and the CVEs behind the issue. In this instance, there's an SQLite old version involved with a critical CVE. I can go even deeper into the finding, but the fix is easy as building the same container with latest image. Aikido is well worth the hype. To try it out yourself, go to aikido.dev, create an account and add your image, repositories and even cloud accounts to start scanning. Next on the list, while not a purely security tool, atac initials stand for arguably a terminal API client, or in other words, postman for the terminal. Yet again, a project with an exaggerated list of installation options and releases, and I'm saying that in the best way possible. It has a long list of features in the docs, showing what it can't or cannot do. Some of these are coming soon, but for most use cases, atac does 95% of requests, no pun intended. Another addition to my home flake, and Darwin sets it for me. Now, to make use of it in a fun way, let's open public APIs, a GitHub repo with over 300,000 stars dedicated to public available APIs. You can have hours of fun just exploring this repo alone. You can find here all kinds of stuff, including random endpoints with dog videos like these corgis in the snow for no reason at all. Let's be grown-ups about it and use a serious endpoint for Chuck Norris jokes. To run atac, you're going to have to add -d for the collection destination. I'll just use my local path and run it. Since my list is empty, I'll hit N to create a new collection. I'll hit N again, and now I'm also offered to create a request. The left pane is your navigation tree, and my check request shows the method, URL, request and response information with tons of useful features. The menu on the bottom changes as you move. So let's go ahead and hit U for the URL, pop the endpoint there and hit space to send it. Once the response is in, it's shown in the right pane. Note that tab circles the left request pane tab and shift tab circles through the response to the right. You can create as many collections and requests within them, all stored in the path mentioned earlier, so you have the persistency and can keep working with atac on your project or in any other context, just like with Postman. You can find a list of key bindings in a configurable TOML file on the main repo, and there's also a vMotion example for those who want it like me. Speaking of Vim, atac has a separate NeoVim plugin that can pop the interface inside a NeoVim session for maximum comfort. Moving on, I mentioned monitoring local traffic in the intro. The go-to for most users is Wireshark. Wireshark comes with a built-in CLI named T-Shark, but T-Shark is quite raw. So today we're looking at termshark, a TUI wrapping over T-Shark. It's written in Go, with almost 9,000 stars on GitHub, termshark is super convenient when you want to sniff packets and get to the bottom of things. Just for reference, this is what T-Shark looks like out of the box. It's okay if you're dumping things into a file that's going to be inspected later, but for a more involved approach, I'm adding termshark to my flake, and when it's called, you can see this. A stream of packets with their information below next to a hexadecimal representation. You can tab through other panes, scroll through the information below, and expand lines on each packet to explore data within it. The question mark pops the menu where you can find different options like backslash for zooming in and out, pipe to change the layout and toggle through it, tab to move around panes, etc. Before exiting, you're even offered to save the session so it's workable later from Wireshark as well. Last on our list, and my personal favorite, Portal. a file transfer utility between computers built with charm bracelet, which is always easy on the eyes. Portal is one of the tools you actually have to have so many installation options, as it's necessary on both the sending and receiving end, and we'll do that in just a second. Locally, as with all others, it's part of my home flame, as all other configurations you see here is always available on my .files repo on GitHub. Sending a file with Portal is as easy as portal send and the target file. I'll use the secret image from earlier. In this instance, it's not encrypted, but I'd probably use age to encrypt it in real life. The tool goes to waiting mode and asks for a receiving command on the other end. Let's use sshs to find my local board and ssh into it. Per the installation, since this is a sandbox server, I'll go for the simplest CURL option and let it run. Portal is ready and I can run the receive command. Sure enough, secret.jpg, earlier encrypted with age, is accepted by a server connected using sshs and sent using portal. Isn't that a good closure? Let's make sure it's home safe by searching the visual interface of the board. Under home/casaos, there's secret.jpg sent and received safely. With these tools under your belt, I'm sure you can improve your terminal workflow, never having to live it while working and making everything happen with open source from one space. However, it's best if you get to know more basic tooling mentioned earlier. So in this video, I cover my entire terminal workflow end to end with tools and tricks you must know. Make sure to check it out. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.